My name is Lars Leijonborg. Most of my life I've been a Swedish politician, and in 1971 I was elected as president in an organization called Young Liberals. And everything started that we were very engaged in the refugee situation with people fleeing from Bangladesh or East Pakistan. In the beginning, I don't think people were so aware of the situation. It was another conflict far away in Asia, and the degree of interest was not so high. Then when the reports come in about the refugee situation, people started to ask what to do about this. And in that situation, I think our position, that we had a very clear position, we met great interest of our position. And the fact that I have been here in Bangladesh and could report live, so to say, from refugee camps and from liberated areas, made the interest of what I have to say greater. In the refugee camps, you saw a lot of dead people, you saw a lot of ill people, sick people, so the situation was very, very bad. But on the other hand, you have to admire the Indian government. They made enormous efforts to solve the situation and to try to do their best to be good hosts for the refugees. I think this was the biggest refugee catastrophe ever happened. So people realized that the rest of the world have to do something. First of all, to send relief to the camps, but in the next stage also find a political solution. People arguing that we can't solve all problems in the world by dividing states. They have to solve the problem within Pakistan. But a lot of people realize that in this case, that was not a realistic alternative. So they began to support the creation of Bangladesh. Even my starting point was that, once upon a time, India was divided into India and Pakistan, and I divided one more time. So I was skeptical in the beginning, but when I learned more, I realized that in this case, due to language problems and the geographical situation and cultural differences, the absolute most natural solution was the creation of a new state. We used a lot of channels. I was invited to television and I wrote articles. My friend had taken a lot of pictures, photographs. So when we published articles, we also send some photographs. We could call ourselves the first Swedes in Bangladesh, and the newspaper liked that. So we got some headlines on that. An advantage with that was that some of this article we could sell, so we got some money for them, because we have to the ticket to Bangladesh we have to pay ourselves. So, and we were poor students, so we need some financing. So I'm very, very grateful to the Bangladesh government that they have invited me, and I'm very, very honored to get this opportunity to see what they have received. I have never been here during the meantime, and I have been in India several times, but never in Bangladesh. And I must say that there is a lot of change, and to a lot of respects to the better, absolutely.